3D will give you an amazing visual of your garment, but you're still not getting away from that tech pack, friend. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. 3D can do an excellent job helping you visualize your design. But like anything else, you still need to know and understand what you want and clearly communicate that to someone. And designers do that with a fashion tech pack. Fortunately, both Browzwear and Clo3d have an option right in the program to generate a tech pack. So let me show you how to do that in Clo3d, and I'll share with you my list of pros and cons. And make sure you stay till the end, and I'll give you my overall assessment of this tool, what parts I think are most helpful, and what's maybe not as helpful. The first thing you're going to need to do is set up a Clo3d account. Now, you can do a lot of things using Clo3d, but we're going to specifically focus on generating and downloading the tech pack. I would also suggest you customize and set up your company profile. Replace the placeholder icon with your company logo, add the correct company name if it's not already populated, so that once the tech pack is downloaded, that information will already be placed in the tech pack. The other thing you should be aware of is that you will not be able to use the tech pack feature on a free plan. You will need to upgrade to an advanced plan, which does give you a 60-day free trial, and you don't even have to add a credit card, which is nice. Okay, so once that's all set up, open your Clo3d file. We're just going to say you have all the info, trims, POMs, colorways, everything you need for your tech pack already finalized. And you're going to click the little cloud in the upper right corner and choose Tech Pack via Clo3d. Once it's ready, you get a pop-up that says your design is ready to upload to Clo3d, and you'll hit OK. It'll open to this page. You'll choose where you want to upload to the company library or a workroom, and then choose Next. In the next screen, Clo3d will automatically begin generating the tech pack. And it might take a minute or two, so just be patient. When it's done, it will have downloaded a file that you can open in Excel. And here's what you find when you open it. The first page shows a front, back, and both side views of the 3D version of the design. And note that it will show it in whatever colorway you had showing last in the 3D window. The header information is taken directly from Clo3d and your files, which is why I suggested you spend some time updating some of your basic info like company name, brand, adding your logo, etc. The next page is called a cutter's much, which is very helpful for the pattern and sample maker. It basically shows all of the patterns that complete the design and all the pieces that must be cut before you pass this off to the sample maker to stitch it together. Next is the BOM. And if you have more than one colorway, there will be a separate BOM tab for each colorway. This is your bill of materials that lists all fabric and trim that's used in the garment. One thing to note here is that it'll be really important for you to use your colors and your trims while you're in Clo3d so that they're labeled correctly when it's brought over to the BOM in the tech pack. If there was a graphic, that would show on the next page. And the last tab lists the measurements. And this is, of course, really helpful for the spec. I love that it shows a thumbnail of how the measurement was taken, both 2D and 3D. And it looks like the measurements are listed in inches now, which was once an issue. Previously, they were listed in millimeters and you had to manually convert them to inches. One thing to note here is that you have to add the POMs. This is not something that automatically generates. So if you didn't create your own POMs, you're not going to see anything on this page. Okay, so here's what I like. First of all, the fact that there is even an option to generate the tech pack, even if it's not perfect, is super helpful. Also like that you have the 3D visual as part of the tech pack. I love that the consumption is generated, as long as you set up the marker correctly, on the BOM and calculates the price for you based on the consumption. And I absolutely love that on the measurements page, there's a 3D and 2D thumbnail that provides a visual guide for how that measurement was taken. However, there's still a lot of tweaking you'd have to do to really make this complete, especially if all of your information in Clo wasn't. First, the header needs a style number and a description, and if you didn't complete the setup in Clo set, you'll also need to update the brand, company, logo, season, line info, and then that has to go on all the pages. In my tech pack template, if you fill out the first page, it will automatically populate the headers for the rest of the pages, and I wish this tech pack would do the same thing. Is it that hard to copy and paste the header on all the pages? It's not, but it's also not very efficient. Most of the other corrections I would need to make stem from not having things labeled in Clo initially. For instance, in the cutters must, all of the patterns are labeled with a generic number instead of them saying skirt front, skirt back, skirt flounce. On the BOM pages, the wool needs to be more specific, like the fiber content and fabric information needs to be specified, the mill and the mill reference code. The marker or print layout should have been done, and some of these things, if you're working with a team, they'd be completed so that when you get to the point of specifying this information, it's already labeled. Like when I was working for Champion, we had a fabric team that would have entered all of the information so that the designers can just plug and play. But a lot of us who don't have a large team or don't have a team at all will need to do this ourselves, so just make sure you don't skip it. Also, if you look at the zipper, Clo didn't automatically populate a placement or quantity for this. So overall, I do like the shell that's generated from Clo, and I do think it can be a good starting point if you need to create a tech pack. Just know that you're not going to be able to just generate it and be done. You're going to have to do some tweaking. Having said that, I do think a flat sketch is clearer. The 3D rendering definitely gives you a good sense of what this garment should look like on the body. But there are a lot of details that are hard to see. It could be because this skirt is pink, but I'm not convinced that just having this 3D rendering is enough. The other thing is, even though a 60-day trial is pretty generous, and I know Clo3d does other things, I think it's a little whack that I have to pay for Clo and pay for this too. Perhaps I'll find more value in it as I use it more. We'll see. But right now, Clo's getting the side eye. One thing I will say is that I think because tech packs can be so time consuming and a little harder to understand, many people are trying to find the easy solution, which is something that you can just push a button and the tech pack is done. And as of this recording, there's nothing like that. And I don't think there ever will be. There are ways to create a tech pack more efficiently, but no one but you knows exactly what you want and can convey your vision best. So even though there might be someone who is helping you use the software and doing the actual tech pack, you still have to let that person know what you want. So regardless of whether you're the one who's actually pushing the buttons, you need to know and understand what information is needed and how to get that information for your tech pack. Thanks for watching today's video. If you need to better understand tech packs and how to get the information that needs to go into one, click the link in the description to sign up for my Creating a Fashion Tech Pack course. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.